Who's making your romantic choices? Who's picking the man you date, the man you're attracted to, and your behaviors when you're out on a date? Is it your heart, or is it your head, or is it your body? Okay, so I have a recent article where I wrote about it. I put it on Medium, I put it on my Substack, I put it on my LinkedIn as well, so you can go check that out. Okay, but you see, a lot of women, including my past version of myself, used to make dating decisions and choices and even behave myself and showed up in a way that the one making the decisions were, at some point it was my head, and at some point it was my heart, and a lot of points it was my wounded feminine self-concept, which I was not aware of, you know, because often we're not aware of our wounded self-concepts. Okay, and I've learned that those are not gonna give you optimal results in your dating life when you're just deciding from your head. You're gonna make decisions and pick men that seem like they look good on paper, and they may even be practical choices, but they're not necessarily gonna make your heart and your feminine energy feel like, you know, you're lit up like a Christmas tree. It's not gonna feel juicy. It's gonna feel like you're it's not gonna feel romantic, you know. And then when you follow your heart without your head, you're gonna go for chemistry, for passion, for excitement, for butterflies in your stomach, and you're not gonna filter the man and his behaviors and the way he shows up through the wisdom of your head. You know, you're not gonna care if he's respectful of you, if he's consistent, if he's you know, genuine, if he's truly committed, or if he's just there also for the chemistry or the convenience, you know. And so what's optimal is when you follow both your wisdom, your soul's wisdom, your head. So there's got to be some practicality, some compatibility, and your heart. You know, the guy has to feel good. His mere presence has to light up your feminine energy. You know, it feels juicy, it feels delicious. And I've had such connections before, albeit it wasn't consistent, so I had to let that one go. But that's a sign of growth, right? When you're able to let go of such juicy connection without drama, that's a sign of growth. Because before, whenever I would let go of someone, there had to ensue a lot of drama. So yeah, if you want to learn more about the work that I do, come to my world, download the free copy of my chapter 7 of my ebook, Awaken the High Value Queen Within, and heal your self-worth, embody authentic femininity, and manifest your true king. So this ebook and everything I teach are all about healing your self-worth, becoming and up-leveling to that high value version of yourself, and operating your life from there, making choices from there, and thus manifesting things from that up-leveled self-concept, from that healed self-worth, from embodying authentic femininity. Yeah, this is Vinyl Joy Calling. Log into vinyljoycalling.com.